Let's talk more about the brewing international tensions over Syria with British MP George Galloway on the line there. Hi, George. Good evening to you. I imagine you voted against intervention, I guess. Tell me why.
I did. I spoke in the debate and I voted against the intervention. And your correspondent in Washington's resume of the situation was pretty perfect. Not since Napoleon scarpered from the gates of Moscow in a sledge being pulled by huskies, has a world leader had to make such an ignominious retreat. David Cameron last night suffered the very first British government defeat on a matter of war and peace since the Crimean War in the 19th century. And that's a very long time ago, even in politics.
Was anything that was said tonight by Obama and by John Kerry altering your opinion at all?
No, although I noticed that the numbers David Cameron was praying in aid of his plan of the number of dead killed in the chemical weapons attack has multiplied by five times. So I don't know if they didn't share that intelligence with the British Prime Minister or whether for propaganda purposes this crime, for such as it was, a very grave and dastardly crime, is now being multiplied to the power of five. The reality is, nobody's arguing that the Syrian regime, or indeed any regime, faced with an existential threat to its existence, are not bad enough to use chemical weapons in their defense. The question is, are they mad enough to use chemical weapons? And I insist that it would be simple madness, indeed a new definition of madness, for the Syrian regime, which is winning the war, and the Syrian opposition, with all its head-cutting and heart-eating, losing sympathy all over the world. And on the day that a UN chemical weapons inspection team arrived in Damascus, for the Assad regime to launch a chemical weapons attack in Damascus.
I wonder why.
Just half an hour from the hotel in which the inspectors were billeted.
I wonder why tonight John Kerry, in his speech, said that the full intelligence report won't be released. Surely that would have been the thing to do, to dampen voices like your own.
Well, of course, as I was listening to him on your program there, I recalled bitterly all the high confidence, full confidence, top conference and top secret, all the James Bond speak. I recalled it all from the debates leading up to the war on Iraq. And those of us who were saying that these are all lies were treated as either fools or worse by the so-called mainstream media and political class here in the West. But we were right, and they were wrong, except where they were deliberately telling us lies, which is, of course, worse than being wrong.
President,
if they are so confident about this intelligence, why don't they publish it?
Are you surprised, briefly, that President Obama still seems to be hesitant about going forward here with an intervention? He still doesn't seem to have made a decision, apparently.
Well, this is George Bush all over again, I'm afraid, but this time without the benefit of their traditional ally, Britain. In Britain, in France, in America, hardly anyone supports getting involved in this war as Al-Qaeda's air force. Hardly anyone at all. President Obama is making a grave mistake, so grave I think he cannot properly comprehend it, by entering into this war, because once he enters into it, it's going to be much more difficult for him to get out of it.
British MP George Galloway, thank you for your thoughts on RT International tonight.
Welcome.